A sentenced prisoner reveals a shocking story Nnamdi Kanu told him in detention. Revealed what will happen to Biafra if he dies eventually. I greet you, my dear listeners in the house. Irrespective of where you are listening to me, I say you are well done for paying attention patiently and also sending us mails and commenting on each of our broadcasts. In fact, you are very much doing well. Thank you so much. We are grateful. Well, in this very broadcast, one of the prisoners in the DSS custody by name Chukwuemeka Nnaboike have said that Nnamdi Kanu told him something so shocking, which he believed that it is true because he actually observed it before he was captured. Though he wasn't in detention because of Biafra, you understand? But then, based on what Nnamdi Kanu has told him, he said that what he said is bound to happen if he eventually dies. What has he truly told? What has Nnamdi Kanu told him, and what will happen to Biafra if anything happens to Nnamdi Kanu? And why is Nnamdi Kanu still speaking about that? Let's check the content. This is Morning News. One of the prisoners in DSS custody has just been sentenced to life imprisonment. Nnaboike, a prisoner in DSS custody, a very close pal to Nnamdi Kanu in detention, has revealed a shocking story. According to Nnaboike, Nnamdi Kanu is the true born of the Biafra Republic. In fact, he is the appointed one and the chosen one from Chukwuemeka. Nnaboike made us to understand that God Almighty intentionally brought Nnamdi Kanu to the world the same day the war broke out. Nnaboike said that nothing will stop Nnamdi Kanu in the struggle, rather aside from death. Nnaboike said that Nnamdi Kanu made him to understand the importance of the Republic of Biafra and why it must come to pass. He said Nnamdi Kanu has told him that Biafran is his life and his life is Biafra. He was born for this purpose, and for that purpose it must be achieved. Nnaboike has pleaded to all and sundry to give Nnamdi Kanu the support that he deserves because he has the opportunity of still living again. I don't believe he's going to die, but then he must be supported. Okay, Nnaboike, you have said it all. You understand? You have said it all, and you've actually spoken well as well. You see, there is something that I really want you to understand, and that is for the fact that Nnamdi Kanu is someone that no one can play or toy with. He was born for this purpose, and for this purpose he will surely achieve it. I've also for once said it before, that for someone to come to the world the same day the war broke out, and now he's now seen being the one fighting for the Republic, know it that is the chosen one. And among all the agitators, because it's not only IPOPO, we also have other agitating group We have BZE, we have MASOP, we have BNL and all of that. It is IPOP that is known as the strongest group for the struggle for Biafran freedom, of which Nnamdi Kanu happens to be the leader. So is that not clear enough? Is that not clear enough? It is, my dear people. Very much clear. So I never doubt Nnamdi because it is the reality. And when you look at what is happening around us right now, you will see the truth in what Nnamdi Kanu just said. Look at it. Nnamdi Kanu is in detention, yet is getting the support of international communities. He's getting the support of international country, organization and group, and international business tycoons. This is the same person they were pointing finger at, calling him a terrorist and all of that. But look at today, he's the one gaining the support of all and sundries. Abi? Oh, so what are we saying? Who are we fooling then? Please let me hear from you, my dear people in the house, to know what you have to say on this that has just finally been reviewed. Yes, don't forget to leave your comment below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.